Welcome to the viewers for the lecture in the subject structural analysis. Now we are discussing about the influence line for the force in members of determinate trusses. Already in the last two lectures, namely lecture number 52, in lecture number 51 we have discussed a Warren girder. Lecture number 50 we have discussed a Pratt truss with the introduction. Right. Now in this lecture we will take a Pratt truss. So in the earlier two lectures, namely lecture number 50 and 51, we have discussed with the members on the top chord horizontal. Now the top chord members are inclined, with inclined chord members. Inclined chord members. Earlier it was horizontal. So that is the difference. Right. Now how to analyze the truss for getting the member forces using influence lines? First one, always influence line is due to a moving unit load. Then whether it is UDL or point load or several loads, it is a question of application and getting the force in the member. That we know already. Right. Now we will straight away take up the problem of a Pratt truss with inclined chord. So the problem is, the question is, for a bridge truss shown in figure, draw the influence line diagram for the forces in the members CD, CG, HG and CH. So that is the question. Now let us name the number CD as P, member CG as Q, member HG as R and member CH as S. We have got four members P, Q, R and S, for which we have drawn the influence line diagram, that is due to a moving unit load. So how the force varies in the member when a unit load crosses from one end to the other end of the bridge truss? Right. That is the question. Right. Now, let us start from a particular member, say ILD 4. ILD for force in P, the top chord member. Right. Now for getting influence line diagram for the force in a particular member, we are using method of sections. So pass a section cutting that member and cutting not more than three members in total. So we have cut the member, we have passed a section through members P, Q and R. So it cuts the member under consideration and it cuts not more than three members. That is to be satisfied. Right. Now ILD for force in the member P, the other two cut members are Q and R. So now we have cut the truss here. So this is the cut section. Cut section. Now before cutting, there will be a force in the member P, there will be a force in the member Q, there will be a force in the member R. Now these cut members, the other two cut members meet at a point. So this is actually member R. When the other two cut members are extended, so they meet at the point G. Now, G is the point where the other two cut members meet. So we have to apply the unit load at G. Unit load at G. Moment center is also G. Where the other? Because when you find out the force in the member P, if you choose this point where the other two cut members meet, these will not come into the picture. Because Q passed through the point G, R passed through the point G, they will not come into the picture. So straight away we can get the force. Right, that is one point. So G is the point where we have to apply the unit load, and G is the point about which we have to take the moment. Right. So we have to apply the unit force at this point. At this point. Right. When we apply the unit force at the point G, when we consider the whole truss, G is the midpoint. Therefore, the reaction here will be 1 by 2. Reaction will be 1 by 2 because G is the midspan. So we need not take moment about B and find out the value of RA. RA is 1 by 2. It is obvious. Obvious. Right. 1 by 2. Now we have to take moment about G. So taking moments about G, 1 by 2 into up to the point G, the distance is 20 meters, total is 40 meters, up to the point G it is 20 meters half into 20 plus P. This is the important point here. P is an inclined member, inclined member. So when we take moment about this point, we have to find out the perpendicular distance to that member. We have to find out the, so we want this distance. This distance. Right. For getting this distance, say let us call this as P dash or D dash, because this is D. This is C, this is H, this is G, this is 10 meters, this is 8 meters. Now, we want this value of theta. Only when this value of theta is known, we will be able to find out this distance. For getting this, we have got a clue, that is, when you draw a horizontal here, horizontal here. Now this value equal to 2 meters, because this is 10 meters, this is 8 meters, therefore this is 2 meters. This distance is known, this is 10 meters. Therefore, this value theta equal to say opposite side is 2 meters by 10 meters equal to 10 theta. Opposite side is 2 by 10 equal to tan theta. Equal to opposite side by this equal to tan theta. Therefore, theta equal to tan inverse of 2 by 10. So, tan inverse of 2 by 10 equal to 11 degree. Equal to 11 degree. 18 minutes 36 seconds. 11 degree 18 minutes 36 seconds. Now considering these two triangles, namely this triangle, this is one triangle, this is the next triangle. Now this angle is common to both triangles. Now, this angle is 90 degrees. In this angle is 90 degrees. 90 degrees. Therefore, when this is theta, this is also theta. Also theta. Therefore, when this is 11 degree, 18 minutes, 36 seconds, D dash G is what we want. D dash G is what we want by GD. That is, this is 90 degrees, this is the base, because this is theta, this is hypotenuse. So, base by hypotenuse equal to cos theta. Cos theta. Therefore, D dash G equal to GD into cos theta. GD is known. GD is 10 meters. That is already known. 10 into cos 11 degree 18 minutes 36 seconds. So that value equal to 9.806 meters. So this value equal to 9.806 meters. Right. Now coming to this. So that calculation is extra. When the card members are inclined, we have to do some extra calculations, but procedure is same. Procedure is same. We'll have to do some extra calculations in finding out the perpendicular distance or moment center and so on. Right. Therefore, it is half into, when you take moment about G, it is 1 by 2 into 20 plus P into the perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance is 9.806. So that is one force. We are taking moment about the point. This is one force. P is another force. Q is the third force which pass through the point that will not cause any moment. R is also another force that is also passing through the point. Therefore, we have completed all the forces. We have considered part of the truss to the left of the cut section. We have considered the equilibrium of the truss on the left hand side. Considering all the forces. So, and we are taking moment about a point G. G is a pin joint where the moment equal to 0. So that will give P equal to minus 1.02. Therefore, P equal to 1.02 compression. P equal to 1.02 compression. So let us draw the influence line diagram later. P equal to 1.02 compression. Actually, for want of space, I am leaving time for the time being. Right. Even now we can just do, but we cannot draw it to the full length. It is the influence line diagram for P will be, so starting from the point A up to the point B, we have drawn the diagram. At the point G, where we have applied the unit load, we have to substitute 1.02. It is a midpoint, therefore it is minus. Therefore, it is to be drawn below the horizontal line. So this value is 1.02. So this is the ILD for force in P. So we have, what you have to remember is we have to draw this from A to B. And because it is compressive, we have just marked it downwards. So this is one way of doing. The other way of doing is the influence line diagram, the ordinate will be the value of mu g by h, height of the truss. Mu g is the ILD as a simply supported beam. Of course, for the point G. If it is a simply supported beam, we know that the ILD will be a triangle having a maximum ordinate of x into L minus x by L. To the point G, x is 20 meters, L minus x is 20 meters by L. L is 40 meters. So this is equal to 10. So 2 into 20, 40 by 4 equal to 10. That is the influence line ordinate. So that divided by the height of the truss. Actually, this is the value of mu g. Bending moment as a simply support beam is x into L minus x by L equal to 10. By the height of the truss, height of the truss is also equal to 10. 10 by 10 equal to 1. So this we are getting it approximately as 1.02 when we take moment about the point g. So mu g by h. So on seeing this formula, one need not get confused. Draw the inflation as a simply supported beam. But this procedure, what the procedure that we follow is common for all members. Whereas this procedure may be applicable for the top chord member or bottom chord member. For inclined member, we have to go for the shear equation. So only to avoid that, we just follow the same procedure for all the members. So 1.02 compression is over. Right. Why I have written A to B means we have to draw the diagram from A to B, because I observed a number of students to draw a small diagram, just a small diagram. This is the influence line. So that will not give you a clear picture that it starts from the point A, it goes up to the point B. That is more important. You have to draw it for the full length. That is very important. That is why I am marking A and B also. Right. Next. So that completes the influence line diagram for the force on the member P. Suppose this is due to the moving unit load. This is the variation of the force in the member P depending upon the position of the load. If the load is here, the load is here. If the given load is here, the load into this ordinate will give you the force in that member. If the load is here, it will have the maximum force. Load is at the center. Where the ordinate is maximum, the force in the member will be maximum. So that is rolling load concept. Of course, that has to be applied, because sometimes they will give, if the truss is traversed by a load of some 20 kilonewton per meter and of length 6 meters. Means this being the center, you have to place 3 meters load on the left, 3 meters load on the right. Right? So this is 20 kilonewton per meter divided by the area. Divide by the area. Intensity of load divided by the, multiplied by the area of the influence line diagram below the load will give the force in the member due to the given load system. That is application. So we have just drawn only the influence line. That is the application. Depending upon the load, you have got five different types of loads. You have to apply the load such that the force in the member is maximum. You know the rules. According to the rules, you will have to apply the given force and find out the force in the member due to the given load system. So what is drawn is only due to your moving unit load. That one has to be very clear. Right. Next is ILD for Q. ILD for Q. We know in the case of a simply supported truss, all the top chord members will be under compression and all the bottom chord members will be under tension when it is subjected to downward loading. That everyone knows. Whereas the inclined members will change its force. For some, up to some position of the load, the member will act as a compression member. Beyond that section, the same member will act as a tension member. So stress reversal will be there. Therefore, now coming to the member Q, here also we have to pass a section cutting the member Q under consideration and cutting not more than 3 members. So same section holds here also. Right. Now, the other two cut members here, other two cut members are P and R. P and R. P and R, now they are not parallel members because member P is inclined, member R is horizontal. They will meet. Therefore, this is D. So when this line is extended, because this is 10 meters, this is 8 meters. So this line, when it is extended, it will meet at some point O outside the truss. Therefore, actually, for want of space, this will call it as X. This is 10 meters. Therefore, this is X plus 10. So at what point it meets, the two lines meet? So here, this is 10 meters by the total distance is X plus 10. So 10 divided by X plus 10. This 10 meters by X plus 10 equal to 8 meters by X. Therefore, 10x equal to 8 into x plus 10 equal to 10x equal to 8x plus 80. So 10x minus 8x equal to 2x equal to 80. So x equal to 40 meters. So this is equal to 40 meters. So this is the point where the other two cut members meet. X equal to 40 meters. We know that this point is A. Therefore, this AO equal to 30 meters. So that is the point where the other two cut members meet. Therefore, we have to take moment about the point where the other two cut members meet. Right. Now, we have to apply the unit force. So there is no meaning in applying the force at 30 meters away from the spot. That will not cause anything. Therefore, what we are going to do here, this is the cut section. We will apply the unit force here once. Then we will apply the unit force here. Next, find out what happens to the force in the member Q. So unit force will be applied at H and G. Once beyond the cut section, next within the cut section, find out what happens to the force. But the moment center is O, because only when you take moment about the point O, even though it is outside the truss, it is the point where the other two cut members meet. So only when we take moment about the point O, we will be able to eliminate these two forces, because this force when extended pass through the point O. The force R when extended, because we know that this is P, this is R, and we are dealing with this member Q. So we have to eliminate P and R. Therefore, take moment about the point O. But unit force will have to be applied only within the span. There is no meaning in applying the unit force outside the truss. But this being an inclined member, we will apply the force within the cut section once, and after the beyond the cut section next. That has to be clear. Right. Now, let us apply the unit force beyond the cut section, namely G. So, unit force at G. Moment center is O, because we have to eliminate the other two members. Moment center is O. It is outside the truss. Right. Now, another difficulty is, when you apply the unit force at the point G,
I think now we can rub off this figure. This will confuse you. Right. We are applying the unit force at the point G here. Here. Right. Now, since moment center is here, away from this force when extended, will cause a force about this, will cause a moment about this point. That is, I'll just make use of the same diagram. Analysis is easy, but the extra calculations one has to clearly understand. That is, when this force Q is extended, we can find out the perpendicular distance. To this point O, what is the perpendicular distance? So, when this angle is 90 degrees, so that we can say the line of action of Q can be extended, Q into the perpendicular distance. You can take moment about the point O. Right. Now, for getting this, let us calculate this value theta 1, or I will write it here. This is theta 1. On theta 1, this is 8 meters, this is 10 meters. So, 8 by 10 will give theta 1. So, theta tan theta 1 equal to 8 by 10, so this is 8 meters, this is 10 meters, tan theta 1. Therefore, we can find out the value of theta 1. Theta 1 equal to 38 degree 39 minutes 35 seconds. That value we'll have to calculate. For this we have data. This is 8 meters and this is 10 meters. So you can easily find out tan theta. Right. Now, this happens to be theta. So this is the opposite side. Let us call this as H. Let us call this as H. And let us call this point as O1. You want this angle to be 90 degrees. Therefore, This is the base. This is the opposite side. This is the hypotenuse. Right. O O1 by the opposite. This is hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is 50 meters because we know OA is 30 meters. 30 plus 10 plus 10 equal to 50 meters. That is OG. OO1 is the opposite side. This is the hypotenuse. Opposite side by hypotenuse equal to sine theta. Sine theta 1. Therefore, OO1 equal to OG is 50 meters and sine theta 1 is 38 degree 39 minutes 35 seconds. So that is the value. So that value is 31.235 meters. So this value equal to 31.235. So these calculations will be extra in this problem. Otherwise, there is no difficulty in the procedure. Right. So now we can take moment about the point. Moment center is O outside the truss. Now, when we apply the unit force here at the point G, we know the reaction is 1 by 2 because G is the mid-span, reaction is 1 by 2. So when you take moment about the moment center, it is, so here we have a reaction. At this point A, we have a reaction. So here we have a reaction. Now our point is outside the truss. The point O is here. So it is minus 1 by 2 into 30 meters, because OA equal to 30 meters, plus Q into, because P when it is extended pass through this point, need not bother about it. R when it is extended pass through the point, they will not interfere. Only Q, the force Q when it is extended into the perpendicular distance, 31.235. So Q into 31.235, then other forces, we have a reaction, we have P, that will not cause any moment because that pass through the point, R pass through the point, Q into the perpendicular distance we have accounted, and unit force is beyond the cut section, we need not bother, equal to 0. Unit force is there, but unit force is beyond the cut section. Therefore, that will not cause any force. So, it is minus 1 by 2 into 30 plus Q into 31.235, that will cause a tensile force of, so this will give Q equal to 0.480. It is with a positive sign, therefore it is tensile. Therefore, when the unit force is at G, the member Q will be under tension, having a maximum ordinate of 0.48 below the point G. So G, it is 0.48 tension. So this is for the time being. Let us have the value. Right. So now we have applied the unit force beyond the cut section. Now we will again apply the force within the cut section. Right. Unit force when it is applied here before the cut section. Now the reaction will be different. Reaction will be Ra into 40 minus 1 into 30 equal to 0. Ra will be 30 by 40 equal to 0.75. So this value is 0.75. Right. Again taking moments. So here also unit force instead of G, it is unit force at H. Right. Moment center is again O only. Right. Now when we take moment about the point O, it is minus 0.75 into 30 meters. Because to the point O, the distance is OA is 30 meters. So minus 0.75 into 30. Then this unit force is now within the cut section. This is the cut section, within the cut section. So within the cut section means plus 1 into 40 up to the point O, namely HO equal to 40 meters. Right. And plus P pass through the point, no problem. R pass through the point, that will not cause any moment. But Q when it is extended, and the line of action is extended, Q into the perpendicular distance plus Q into 31.235, the sum of all these things equal to 0. That will give one more value of Q. Q equal to minus 0.56. That is Q equal to compression. Q is compression. So at the point H, it is 0.56 compression. Therefore, when we draw the influence line diagram for Q, starting from A, this is point A, this is point B. You have to go from A to B, one end to the other end. When the unit load is at G, it is 0.48 tension. So at the point G, it is 0.48. So this value is 0.48 tension. When the unit load is at H, it is 0.56 compression. So when it is at H, it is 0.56 compression. 0.56 compression. Therefore, join this, and join this. So this is minus, this is plus. So this is ILD for the member Q. That is, when the unit load traverses from one end to the other end, when the unit load is at the point H, the member Q will be under compression with a maximum ordinate of 0.56 below H. When the unit load is here, the same member will act as a tension member having a maximum value of 0.48. In between, at some point, it changes. At this point, when the unit load is here, the member will carry zero force. So this is the variation of the force in the member Q when a unit load traverses from left to right, one end to the other end of the truss. So that is for the member Q. Now, ILD for force of the member R, we can make use of the same section will hold good. Now, when we are considering the force in the member R, the other two cut members are P and Q. The other two cut members P and Q meet at the point C. The other two cut members meet at the point C. Therefore, we have to apply the unit load at C. Unit load at C, where the other two cut members meet. Similarly, moment center is also C, where the other two cut members meet. Right. C. Right. When we apply the unit force at the point C, that is above this, namely C here, above H only, this is 1. Unit force at the point C, reaction is 0.75 only. Therefore, taking moment about the point C, it is 0.75 into 10 meters. Vertical force into horizontal distance. So 0.75 into 10 plus you are taking moment about C, therefore 1 will not cause any moment. Coming to R is a horizontal force. R into 8 meters. This height is 8 meters. So minus R into 8 meters. So and P will not cause any moment about this point because that passed through the point. Q also will not cause any moment because that passed through the point. R only will cause, and unit force is at the point C itself, therefore equal to 0. Therefore R will be, on calculation, R will be, because this, when it goes to the right hand side, becomes minus cancelled, equal to 0.93 7.5. Will be getting with a positive sign, therefore it is under tension. It is under tension. Because bottom card member, we know it will be under tension. Top card member, it is under compression. So when you draw the influence line diagram, here again for A to B, it have to draw, you draw it A to B, and unit force applied at C. Therefore, at the point C, that is above the point C, you have to apply this value, because this is under tension, and this also, this is this value equal to 0.9375 tension. This is the ILD for R. ILD for R. So here again, we can find out the value as mu C by height of the truss. That also can be done. Mu C will be for the point C, x is 10 meters, L minus x is 30 meters by 40, x into L minus x by L into 1 by height. 1 by height of the truss is 8 meters at that point. So this also will give you the same value. Mu C by H will also give you the same value. That also can be done. So this is the ILD for the member R. In fact, you have to draw the influence diagram below this. I will do it for only one case. Now, suppose if you take ILD for R, ILD for R will be from A to B, unit load is at C. Here we have to mark the ordinate. The ordinate is 0.9375. This is the influence line diagram for R. So this is how we have to draw. For want of space, we have drawn outside the truss. So this is plus, this is ILD for R. Similarly, you have to draw the ILD for P, Q also below the truss for the entire length. Right. One more member is that of S. And actually, the members, namely CH and EF and also DG. There is a specific term for that member. So, the truss will be stable without, they are called the sub-members. They are called sub-members. Yes. So, enough explanation is not available, but what is given is these members are submembers. Even without these members, the truss will be stable. So when you consider the number of joints, number of members, etc., without those three members, without those three submembers, the truss will be stable. With this, it is a determinate structure, stable structure. Even without those three vertical members, namely submembers, the truss will be stable. Therefore, here the what explanation is available is, when the as far as this member is concerned, when the unit load varies from A to G, the member will carry a force. Unit force is beyond G, the member will not carry any force. When the unit force is applied below H, this member will be under tension. Therefore, the ILD for that will be For this it is 1, for this it is 1, and below G this will become 0. When the load crosses the point G, the submember will not carry any force, because even without those submembers, the member, the truss will be stable, and also determinate. So this is what is given as far as the ILD for the vertical member is given. ILD for S is given. So this for this submember, when the load crosses the point G, that will not carry any force. That is the explanation that is given. So that is ILD for the member. So that completes the ILD for force in the members P, Q, R and S of a prop truss with inclined members. Similarly, we can do it for Warren girder also. Principle is same, but it will involve extra calculations in calculating theta values and the perpendicular distance, the point where the other two cut members meet. For all these things, the calculations will be extra. Procedure is same. I think with this explanation, I think the viewers can do more number of problems and practice, right? So that completes this lecture. Thank you. Thank you for your patience.